Hi again, it's Katrina Marshall, host of the morning talk show Morning Barbados. The last time we spoke, I was going to go to a play called I Have No Son, Rico's Story. It's themed around all sorts of things to do with HIV and AIDS. It centers around the story of a young man who, through a series of unfortunate events, contracts the virus, but is kind of guided along the path to hope, and that's what I liked about it. The acting was great. There were some pretty good twists and turns in the play that I didn't expect. But the end of the story was one of hope, the fact that you can live a relatively normal, productive life after being diagnosed with HIV, with the possibility of it, you know, expanding into full-blown AIDS. So the main character, Rico, was played by a fairly talented actor called Marcus Meyer. We hope to see more of him on screen. And he brought some real authenticity to the role. You can kind of imagine him as a young man at the University of the West Indies, either Cahill Campus or St. Augustine or Mona or wherever, kind of getting caught up in those types of issues and, you know, seeing his reaction to them, whatever else. So, and the same went for the woman who plays the role of his girlfriend. Aisha Gibson played that role, and, you know, they both brought a degree of authenticity and the kind of tentative anxiety that comes with what they call discordant couples, which is where one has the disease and the other does not, and how you navigate that. There's an unborn child involved as well. Here's hoping that the director, Diastra Brown, so big up props to Diastra Brown, manages to get another screening of I Have No Son out soon to perhaps like a matinee audience, younger kids, because there are some themes in there that really need to be brought to a wider audience. So, like I said, job well done to Diastra Brown and his team. Amanda Cumberbatch played the counselor as well. Of course, there was Ishaka McNeil. Andrew Pilgrim played a man who actually brought a really interesting perspective, which is the concept of men sleeping with men. These are not men who identify as homosexuals, but they sleep with men. And it was because of this gentleman, played by Andrew Pilgrim, that the character Rico contracted the virus. But what he did was he created a contrast between early detection, early diagnosis, a healthy lifestyle, and a course of antiretroviral drugs that you can manage, versus ignoring it, not dealing with it, and then having your life on fast forward towards, you know, a fairly gruesome death, open sores and illness and whatever else. So that was I Have No Son, a Rico's Story. Great play, well done to all involved. So the next thing that struck me this week was a little bit sadder, not as much hope involved. It was the story in the online newspaper BarbadosToday.bb. It was a center page spread about a man who pretty much lost everything because his employers and the people he worked with found out that he was HIV positive. Now, okay, so the story in and of itself is horrible because it's more stigma, more discrimination, things that we're trying to get rid of. What hurt me, though, was that this man did what I figure he thought was the right thing. He was upfront with his employer, with one of the managers in the company, about his status. And that was a prime opportunity for that manager to provide support, confidentiality at best, to someone who obviously needed that kind of support. Didn't work out. The whole company eventually found out. He was on a freelance basis, sort of, so all of a sudden there was no more work for him. Please tell me how this helps. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Insensitive, Borderline, Law-Bending Employer. So let me break it down for you. You take away a man's work at a time when you know full well he needs that money more than ever, because he's got to afford drugs, antiretrovirals if he's caught it early enough. He needs nutrition to shore up an immune system that is now weaker than ever because of the very nature of the disease. So then he becomes the responsibility of the state, as does his family, because he can't support them. That puts a strain on the social services, that puts a strain on the private social services, that puts a strain on the drug service, which then puts a strain on taxes. Who do taxes affect the most? You, Mr. Insensitive, Borderline, Law-Bending Employer. Boo hiss to you. 2011 and it's still happening. That's why we work so hard here on ilivup.com to spread the message of tolerance, understanding, and all that fun stuff. Anyway, That was a bit heavy, but ending on a note of hope and joy, hopefully. Before I run off, I want to give a big get real shout out to Toni Thorne and her team at the Settlers West Coast Experience. The West Coast Experience is kind of like a traveling night carnival. It's a small group of bands, body paint, music truck, drinks, merriment, fun, the whole nine yards, through the streets of Barbados' West Coast, usually. And then it ends in a kind of all-inclusive breakfast party. So we had another one of those this past weekend. Apparently it was great. I was a little bit on the sleepy side, so didn't manage that. But heard about it, interviewed them on the show, and what Toni did was she took the breakfast aspect of it and turned it into an opportunity to donate to the HIV food bank. Now, just like the story I just told you about the man that lost everything, there are people living with HIV and AIDS who literally cannot feed themselves. That's something that you and I take for granted. But there are people who need this food bank more than ever. So you can donate, yes, you, those cans of tuna that you're not eating, yes, take them to the food bank, they need them. So you can take them to the food bank, and they provide hot meals, nutritious meals for people who need them, the most people living with HIV and AIDS. So that's what Toni did. Part of the entrance fee for the all-inclusive breakfast was a can of something to donate to the HIV food bank. So big props to Toni for remembering her humanity and the humanity of people around her who are living with this disease and whose families are affected by it, even while creating merriment and joy for those of us who perhaps don't have to think about it quite so much. So big up to Toni Thorne of the Settlers West Coast Experience. Keep up the good work. So that's me signing off for now, reminding you as always to love, protect, and respect. Live up. Bye for now.